You have to see this, what I'm going to show you. It's,
okay.
If not criminal, definitely a sin. Look at this tree.
You mean the chopped down tree?
Yeah, the cut down tree, yeah. This is a beautiful white birch, and it's rare that you see them that big and that fat. And this is an old one. We've had two white birch blights up here in New York that killed off most of the white birch trees. This tree survived through two of those blights. Two. And look what man has done to this beautiful tree.
Okay, I've heard that there's a birch blight. So maybe it was a diseased tree, but
no. No, you know what? They said they cut it down because it was rotten. But I'm going to show you just that it's not, that it wasn't really rotten. It could have been repaired really easy. One branch was rotten. They could have took it off and got it. For what it cost to cut this down and cut it up, they could have got a tree doctor to come in and take care of it. You know?
So you could count the rings on this and figure out how old this tree is.
Yeah, you could. This is an old tree.
How about over here, Joe? Is this a rotten?
Yeah, I'll show you the rotten part.
Okay.
This tree went up and split into two, well, let me show it this way. It split into two big pieces here. Or maybe even three. Yeah, three. You see three?
Uh-huh.
One, two, and there's one down below. Now, that piece right there was on the one down below.
Okay.
That piece has rot in it. This piece here. Right? And it come up, and it went into two pieces. You see one piece here.
Mm-hmm.
And one piece here. There's rot on the
there's
piece.
There's rot on this one?
No, look at, I'm gonna show you where the rest of that one is. The rest of that one's here.
Oh, I see.
This one, this bottom piece here, this bottom piece here was connected to that rotten log. You see how it fits exactly, even to this piece here fits in that?
This one does?
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
This one fits right into this one right here. There's no rot on this one. There's no rot on this one. There's no rot on any of these. There's no rot on this one here. And the rest of that branch there that I showed you, that rotten one,
mm-hmm.
is the other piece to that is over here. But that's only one, all they had to do was cut off one branch.
No kidding.
That's the other piece, and that's all off that one piece. They could have cut that off about halfway up and probably even left this bottom branch on it. Here, let me show you.
Here would be to the outside the only evidence.
No, there's evidence over here on this one, too. Look. This one completely rotted away here. But if they'd have took off this branch down here and put a tree doctors know about this stuff. I don't know what the stuff is they put on it.
Yeah, yeah,
but they could have put the stuff on it and protected it from going any further into the tree.
Look at this. This used to be white, right?
And yeah, that's just
and
age.
As the tree grew older, this shows how many years that this has been around for the new growth to burst out of its skin. I mean, what a beautiful, beautiful
yeah.
old tree. And like Joe said, it was a survivor.
Yeah, what a shame.
Why was it taken down?
What a shame they did this. You're right.
Talking about carbon footprints and saving.
And how many people have given a dollar to plant a tree in someplace else in some other country? And this is what we do in Woodstock?
Yeah. And
this is terrible that they cut this tree down. This is a rare tree.
Really?
Yeah.
It's an old birch.
Old, too. And you can see, there's on these logs here, there's no rot. And on these two here, there's no rot. Shame they.
A guy who liked logs as much as you.
No, this is criminal that they cut down this tree. There's very few white birch in this country. We've had two white birch blights.
Oh, really?
That killed off. You rarely see an old white birch like this. You know.
Shame. We see them. We're from Wisconsin, so we have a lot of them up north there.
Yeah, they're real rare around here. And this was an old one. And it had a little bit of rot. If they cut off the rot and took care of it.
Okay. That's a shame.
Yeah, that's a shame.
Yeah.
Do you know about chaga mushrooms? Chaga mushrooms grow inside the white birch.
Oh, wow.
And they have phenomenal carcinogenic properties. So
we'll have to look.
Yeah.
Because we have a couple close to us.
Yeah. Lucky.
They look like a fungus growing on it. They don't look like a mushroom. They look like it's actually growing on a tree.
Yeah.
It's black.
We've been mushrooming with friends.
Look up chaga. In the Chinese pharmacopoeia, chaga mushroom is the number one herb for healing and for all the positive energy of it.
Yeah, it's the king of Chinese medicine. That's
what about kombucha?
Well, that's all good, but the most valued medicine is the chaga mushroom. And they grow on these kind of trees.
Oh. If you go to Sunfrost, you can buy chaga that's local from here. And you believe me, it's going to go zipping up in price.
It's incredible rejuvenation.
They're not dried.
This isn't just the tree that,
Yeah, they're dried. They're for making a tea with. Sunfrost up the road.
The
vegetable stand on the left hand side going up.
Okay. You go past the post office. The post office is on the right.
Sunfrost.
They have all those pumpkins during
Halloween. Right.
Yeah, go in there and ask for
This is such beautiful wood now that they've done this. They should donate this wood to the artist community for carving. This is really beautiful wood, It's a shame that they cut it down, but someone said they're going to use it for firewood. This tree should not be used for firewood.
No.
This tree should be given to artists.
Right. Well, we should report it as a crime scene to the police so that they can cordon it off and make sure that the wood is protected. Of course, if you cause too much controversy, and a lot of times they destroy the evidence. So we don't want to do that either. We've got
the evidence right here on film now. There's no, how can they deny?
They can deny that, it by grabbing your traffic on the internet.
No, I'm not talking about that.
But we do have that, yeah. But locally, we should be able to. If people care enough or understood. Like Joe was explaining to a passerby before about chaga mushrooms.
I don't think they heard you.
Joe was explaining about chaga mushrooms. You want to say with your nice booming voice?
No, they grow on these kind of trees, Not that there was any on this tree.
But this, what I'm focusing on now was part of the fungus or the blight. That's not chaga. Chaga has a positive symbiotic relationship.
Most people know what a blight is. A blight is when a tree... bug, either an infestation of some kind comes in and kills all the trees of that whatever it is that those bugs eat, or that bacteria sometimes, or whatever it is. But we've had two in my lifetime blights all over the Northeast that killed off the white birch. And to have killed off this old one, this is a really old one. I mean, you know, for such little rot, this is what I was told, that this was cut down because it was rotten. But it's only one, only that one piece of it is rotten.
Right.
And if they'd have cut that off, if, for what it costs to cut this down and remove it, and especially if they're going to use it for firewood, what a waste, you know? To cut it down and haul it away, the man hours and the time, they could have cut that one piece off and had a tree person come in here, someone who really knows about trees, and did something to bring the health back and restore this tree, you know? Woodstock, so stupid. Every tourist would notice this tree when they pulled into this parking lot. Look at the, you know, you couldn't miss this tree when you pulled into this parking lot.
Right. You now know? It's looking like ugly strip malls.
Yeah, now it's looking like a strip mall, you know?
I'm just so impressed with the texture here.
Yeah, let me take a picture of you. Here, give me the camera. Stay right there. Turn around and by the tree.
I just love the texture of this, because when you look on it, you don't think this is a white birch if you saw just this part. Because you always think of the white birch, you know, where it's got that nice parchment.
Where it's like that,
you would,
yeah.
You know, you had old sages writing the ancient cognitions of the divine on bark. But when you come here, it's almost like fossilized. Do you know fossils?
Yeah. No, it's not fossil, but it's aged.
And then this really beautiful part, where it shows how, as the tree's growing, because, you know, when you see the rings of a tree, each ring counts for 1 year. So pretty soon, the skin from previous years isn't big enough, and so the tree bursts through. And so you see that coming up. I mean, to chop this up as firewood would be an absolute travesty, but in the hands of the right artist,
yes,
it would bring out that theme of
it should be given to artists, yes.
Yes.
And we're not saying me and Paula, because we're not doing wood carvings right now.
Oh, you used to do wood carvings.
No, a long time ago. But that's why this should be given to artists at this point in time, now that the town has done this, you know.
Yeah.
It's a crime that they've cut it down. But it'll be a worse crime if they waste this wood, you know, if they don't put it in a good place, you know. For an artist, look at this. Let me just... You see this stump? If this stump was pennied in slices all the way down, because they got to take it out now anyway, look how many nice tabletops that could make, you know? And then we've got...
You could start a whole retail store just on this.
And then we've got this big one. If it was sliced this way, Paula, in slices, look
slice
at the nice
one?
Tabletop. Yes, slice it long ways. So you now have long... Like here you have little round tables. And this sliced this way, you could have long tables.
Yeah, but then you'd lose that nice skin at the top. I guess you'd slice that off and keep that.
Well, no. If you're making new furniture out of it, you know, you want to clean the bark off.
I guess
off.
It's like cutting a gemstone too. See, here's that white, that beautiful, almost chalky white of the white birch.
Yeah.
And that's the skin then that starts to peel off.
And the Indians made canoes with it, by the way.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You never heard of a birch bark canoe?
No.
Boy, you've lived a sheltered life.
Yeah, see here? How it strips off?
Look what they did to this beautiful tree.
up, wasn't it?
A little piece of one, they could have cut it off and sealed it, and they could have saved this tree.
This is my favorite angle.
Ain't this terrible what they did to this tree?
Was it all dead?
One branch was dead. Cut that branch off and had a tree person come in that preserves trees. This tree is a really old tree. We've had two blights here in upstate New York that killed off these kind of trees. This is a rare one. It's not just a tree.
Is this a birch?
Yeah, it's an old birch.
Wow. See the white here, the white here, it's so old you wouldn't even recognize it as a birch.
Winds took it down.
And snapped it at the bottom.
She calls me up and she's crying because one like that fell down.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
It was one we had from when I was a kid.
And it was and it was only about that wide around?
It was only as big as that. And it snapped.
Wow.
So
and it
then,
snapped.
That's criminal. That is criminal. Take
so
down.
You really know. Cause
just this one branch was rotten. If they'd have cut this one branch off,
yep.
We've looked over the whole tree.
Yep.
That piece there was also part of this. It was on this here, on this side.
And last year they were trimming trees along my property, and they took down healthy trees. I mean, they took down a bunch of the dead, the birch, not the birch, the ash that had been eaten by the beetle. But they also dropped a few.
Oh, hang on just a second. Oh, I'll get another one.
I mean, this probably was like over 50-year-old tree, because they grow slow.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sure.
I think I counted over 100, if a ring, or what are you, we'll see.
I'm up to like 40 some right in here.
Oh, 40 there, okay.
That was before the horn started blowing.
You were up in the 40 around here,
right?
Yeah. So you're probably talking.
So you're talking probably another 40.
Yeah,
75 or 100-year-old tree.
But your husband was saying that he'd never seen a tree.
I've never seen a birch this big. No.
No, they're rare.
Not a white birch.
Yeah.
Not we, every expert, but I've seen.
Well, what we're hoping at the very least is we can get some artists to do something
we
beautiful
so
with the wood.
We have so many artists in this community. At least they should donate this wood to those artists.
And they should make
something. We're not artists
or
affiliated with any artists.
They could actually cut this a little shorter and make
tabletops.
Like a table.
That's what we said.
Chairs around it so that,
cut it
I mean, no sense to take
like
it out of the ground.
All the way down. You could get a bunch of nice tabletops out of that.
You could get a beautiful tabletop out of that.
Or if it doesn't crack, see, look at how nice this is that
that's
cracking. You know, it's going to crack some, but you can see it here in this one.
You know, they had to be able to tell somewhere partway down this tree that it was not rotten.
Yeah,
because if you start taking off branches and branches are solid like that.
Yeah.
Oh,
you know, we videotaped
I can show you the few branches. This one here. This one was rotten, pretty much, right? And this piece here is that piece there.
Yeah.
And there's a piece off of that over in that pile.
But you
and
just...
And that's all. All the rest of these, look.
And
no
believe it or not, a lot, what'll happen is the town will come and they'll take this and they'll take it to the landfill.
Yeah.
That's what they do. Take it to the landfill and throw it out. And only certain people... with enough insurance can go onto the landfill and cut the wood.
Wow.
Yep. Where did they cut it down? They didn't like the way it looked?
I don't know.
Well, we're hearing...
Somebody really botched this one up.
Yeah. Well, thank you for... Watch Woodstock TV, community TV.
Okay.
Okay? Yep. What's your name?
Sue Webster.
Sue, thank you so much. I'm Paula Gloria Barton.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Paula Gloria Barton.
In this lot. That's one of the first
that's Joe Barton.
Saw was that
I know.
Tree.
The beautiful tree.
Yeah.
And you know what? You couldn't even just plant one here and just wait another. No. You'd have to wait almost 100 years for it to be
and
like
hope
that.
And hope that it don't die off from the blights that we get every so many years.
Yeah.
Okay,
you
well,
this one built a resistance. It made it through two.
It was a survivor.
Tree.
Yeah.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thanks for doing what you do.
Thank you.
Yeah. It's how many minutes we got?
38 minutes.
It says 19 minutes on the battery.
Okay, let's change the battery. It's not really ready to be changed. this is Paula Gloria, and today I'm Paula Gloria Barton, the complainant, because I'm going to be putting in a complaint to the Woodstock Police, which is right next to Town Hall, now that the Town Hall's been turned into a cop shop. And I'm going to tell the police that a crime has happened and that a very, very old birch tree was chopped down behind, where is it, Joe? How do I describe it? Where the birch tree was chopped down?
Behind the Chamber of Commerce by the parking lot.
Right, behind the Chamber of Commerce by the parking lot, close to Andy Lee Field. So, let's see what happens. Because we have all of the evidence that if the tree was chopped down because they had it had a blight, we're saying no, it didn't have a blight, and it could have easily been fixed up, repaired. Just like we don't want to be thrown into the dustbin, why throw a perfectly good tree that has withstood two rounds of
blight?
And particularly because chaga mushroom is it favors the environment of the birch, so this is a very valuable tree. Joe, you didn't have it on. I hope you had it on before.
No, I probably didn't. But.
So I'll find out if it's town property.
Okay, I'm sorry.
And we'll go from there, all right?
Yeah.
And I'll follow up with you. 901-1114.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay, perfect.
And we've documented.
But I probably won't be able to find out till tomorrow, but I'll have somebody tomorrow during the business hours because I don't know that anybody will be.
Well, we're just concerned that nobody carts it off because we now have the evidence and the footage, and this is our property that we're going to be putting out to the community.
Your property.
No.
The property, the evidence. Okay. The evidence is
not right. The tree.
Got
yeah.
it, right.
And so
let me find out whose property it was and the storyline.
But if the
to try to save
it,
the
we
tree.
Heard, we heard mm-hmm. that whoever did it was going to cut it up for firewood.
Right.
First of all, it's an old tree. This
right.
tree lasted through, I don't know if you know much about white birch.
Right.
White birch is rare around here.
Right.
And we've had two blights that have killed it off all
right.
over. That tree survived two
right.
blights. They're going to say it was rotten, but I went over that whole tree. One branch of it, one section of it, they could have taken off.
Right.
And
so do you know who cut it down?
No, I don't.
No, we don't.
Okay.
That's
no,
why
we
we're
don't.
Coming to you.
And they could have patched where they took it off and saved this beautiful old tree.
Got
I mean,
it.
It's really an old
and we had,
tree.
And we had other people besides us come by.
Yeah,
and talk
a lot
about
of people are
saying that they
not
had,
happy with
one
it.
Guy
it.
Said he never
okay.
saw a birch so old.
All right, so I'll find out whose property it was, and we'll
thank
go from
you.
There. All
thank
right?
you
and
very
I'll
much.
So
even,
give me a day or so, of course. You're
even,
welcome.
Even if it was all legally cut down by the town.
Right.
Save the wood.
They spent money that was unnecessary to be destructive.
Got it. Okay.
What it costs to cut that tree down, as opposed to bring a tree surgeon, someone who
right.
really knows about trees, not me.
I hear you.
You
that
know?
Wouldn't be, that's out of the arena of the police.
Oh, it's misuse of
see.
It's misuse of town.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, guys.
Okay, bye.
This site stood a local market bankrupted by the monopolistic make it cheaper in China, anti-union, big box store where you shop. That was there by the education department. Finally, the education department is educating people. This is a unique sign, people. Live in Woodstock, only in Woodstock. Lights of white birch, and they're very rare, especially one that's 80 years old. Yeah, and this was a beauty, and we took pictures of it. We have it all on film. And only one section of this tree was rotted. You know, they used the excuse that the tree was rotten, but they could have cut off the section that was rotten, which would have been, it as it went up, it went into three sections. One of the three sections had rot. If they'd have cut that off and brought in a tree person who knows how to patch the tree and do something to make the tree healthy again, this tree could have been saved and probably would have lasted a lot, many more years. And it
does sound like a missed opportunity, and that is too bad.
Can I talk to him?
I do think that this would be the right person to talk to.
Can I talk to him?
Okay, my wife wants to talk to you again.
Oh, Charlie, thank you. I just want to be sure, does this lady have the same power that the DEP has? Because the police said it's a DEP problem.
Well, she has private authority within the county, and I mean, so her department, and she heads up the county department of the environment.
When was the Ulster County Department of the Environment formed? Was it formed before the New York City, which I know is the most powerful one?
No, it's relatively new. I mean, she's been there for a number of years now, but it is relatively new.
It's relatively new. Now, does it have the same
Authority
that you do, or the same rules that you do? Because I'm sure that an 80-year-old birch tree, like I say, my husband said, we're not fanatics. We're not going to call up about every tree. It's just this is a particularly old tree, and the blight, it's a survivor. So we need somebody with power, because this is a municipal town board that has bullied the people plenty.
And we want.
Well, I do think your best bet is to go through.
And we want them not to do it anymore, to any more trees.
And, you know, since they work with all the municipalities in the county, including Woodstock, and I do think she is the right person to talk to.
Right, and we also want to be sure that they're aware not to cut down any more of these old trees, you know? I mean, white birch are rarer trees. You know, there's tons of pine, there's tons of maple, there's tons of oak. You know, if they were cutting down one of those, we wouldn't be calling. But to cut down such a rare tree is a real, in my opinion, is a real crime. And if someone came down or even fined a town and said, no, don't do that, they'll think twice before they cut down another old birch.
This does seem to, I mean, I live in Red Hook across the river, and, you know, we've had problems with the town highway department and other agencies cutting street trees down. And, I mean, everybody is so risk-averse and sort of ruled by worries about, you know, litigation and property damage that they, you know, their knee-jerk reaction to any sort of slightly ailing tree is to cut it down, and
this has to stop.
That seems to be their default choice these days, which is a shame.
Yeah, well,
how can we work together to change?
How can we work together to stop people from doing this? That's one of the reasons why. You know, it's too late to save this tree, but a fine, that's all these towns understand is money. If all of a sudden DEP or some agency came in and said, you know what, you shouldn't have done that, we're going to fine you, don't do it anymore, then that would raise their awareness that maybe it's not so good to just cut down old trees, you know, and especially rare trees. You know, it's not so much that there's a lot of old trees around that, yes, if they take them down, that's not as bad. But this tree made it, like I said, through two blights. So it was a survivor, you know?
It's a shame. It's a real shame that they cut down this. And it was one of the most beautiful trees in Woodstock.
It does sound like a special tree. But I think I'm sure you will get concerned if you talk to Mr. Lamar.
Well, thank you very much, Charlie. It's been a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
338-7287 Amanda.
Reached Mandy Wolfson and the main number of the Ulster County Department of the Environment. Please leave a message. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Joseph Barton, and I got your number from the DEP, from Charlie Lang. I'm calling about a white oak tree. White birch tree. This is an 80-year-old tree that has survived two white birch blights. Very rare tree. I wouldn't call about just any old tree. That the town of Woodstock has cut down. Now there's there was a little bit of rot on this tree. It went up into three sections. One section had rot that could have been cut. And if they treated this tree, it would have lasted a long time. And I want to see if someone like you or someone, the DEP said I needed to talk to you. And I'd like to see if maybe we could get the town to make sure that they don't do this to any more old white birch.
I'm being fined.
Would you call me? My number is 845-901-1114. My name's Joseph Barton. Thank you. Bye.
No.
Okay, here I am at the Woodstock Post Office, and I'm going to be mailing a letter to Christian Lorette. And the reason is because my emails aren't being answered by him, and the telephone numbers no longer work. So I'm not sure why. And I just want to make sure that he gets this, and that's why I'm recording it. Now, inside this, I am telling Christian that Joe and I are using his past work. This was when he wrote to the American Civil Liberties Union, and they put $1 million into prosecuting cases of violation of civil rights. And of all the many people applying for a violation of their civil rights out of thousands, Joe was number two for the religious use of marijuana. And here he's laying out his whole argument. So I'm sending copies of this along with copies of letters that he wrote to the lawyer when he was in prison for harming no one, and some extremely touching letters of his wife's. That's what I'm sending these. So what I'm saying is, Christian, Joe is mounting a religious use of cannabis case based on his experiences in 1974 when two juries were getting won over, but dirty tricks were played by the courts. I am writing to you because your email and phone numbers do not work, and I really want to stay in touch with you. Tomorrow, Joe and Jay are called back into the case of 2011 when you did that fabulous call with Michelle Rice. We have a popular Real FM broadcast radio show that is off internet censorship. They took down the beautiful file of Run From the Cure, which had 1,200,000 hits. Remember, Christian Lorette is the one who was the producer of the story of the Rick Simpson story of the cancer cure. This is Joe's letter showing his desire to care for his family and be productive. Very touching, as he writes one of the lawyers and says, "Don't lead my wife on, give her false hope." And he said he didn't think it would do any good, because after he did all of this and the ACLU was going to take his case, but instead they chose the Nazis' right to march. The Nazis' right to march in stogie, they took that over the religious use of cannabis. And this is the letter that his wife wrote to the judge. So here is Yum Yum, and there was the missing. There's more light here because a tree was chopped down. And that's the tree. Yep, there it is. Is this not a beauty?
Yeah.
This is like, this is, you can count the rings and you can see how old it is. But you'll see in all the cut marks, it wasn't diseased. And see, you wouldn't even know it was a birch from here, right? Because it's so old. But look at, you see how that parchment-y stuff, it starts to burst out.
Yeah.
So that means that this stays on for, you know, more than 1 year until finally it bursts through. Unless they're going to say that's the rot. If that's the case, then we just need a tree expert. But it would seem, if that's the rot, how could all of these be so healthy? A very important mushroom called chaga mushroom grows on birch trees, and in Chinese medicine, chaga is considered the king of medicine. And reishi mushrooms are the queen. What do you think? Does it look diseased to you? Joe said this is the part. Right in here.
Oh, okay, I can see that. He's like, it's eating away.
Yeah. But he said if you just had cut off this branch, see this side's healthy. And he said it came from over here. But as Joe pointed out, that was just one of three, as this thing branched off, so you could have just lopped off one of them.
Going by thickness, this problem is very high up the tree. They could have just cut at the top.
That's what Joe was saying, because see, it's split. Here's the main trunk. So whatever part that came off of, a good tree surgeon could have patched it up. But this is... beautiful, isn't it? Now, there was a whole lot more here, so I think people are taking it away. Dear, dear. It's like we're a third world country, huh? Too much garbage around. Much nicer. So I wonder what the Chamber of Commerce has to say about this. I see they've got a smart meter. Ooh. Smart meters. If Steve Romine was here, he could measure this and see, despite all of the festive colors and the nice logo, the fact of the matter is, if we're not aware enough to get this back to an analog meter, well, we're not going to be aware enough to keep freedom, if indeed we ever had it. And we're seeking a remedy. And we called up the police. And the police understood, and they said to go to the DEP. And when we called the DEP to Charlie Lang, he said it was out of his jurisdiction because it was New York City. And I said, well, that doesn't surprise me, because New York City, by federal regulations, is called the United Nations. Five boroughs is made up of five different counties. So we need someone with power in Ulster County. It has to be someone with power. There has to be a natural adversary to a town board that's running roughshod over people.
If there was a small fine and don't do that anymore, you would protect further any destruction to some of these old trees.
But there's nothing that the county can do about that. That's what I'm saying, that the county only has jurisdiction over county property or the county right-of-ways on county roads.
Yeah, but everything, and tourists come up here, if they see a strip mall and there's no trees.
I understand, and certainly it's within the county's interest and everyone who's a resident of the county to try to preserve and protect the natural resources that we have.
If someone like you even just gave them a scolding. they would be a little more.
Well, if someone like me gave them a scolding, they would treat it the same way as if someone like you gave them a scolding. They would treat it even less, pay less attention to it, because I'm not even a resident of Woodstock, so they wouldn't listen to me at all.
You've got an agency name, you know what I mean?
But no one likes
to mess with agencies.
But we don't. We have no jurisdiction. The DEC might, but
well, can you call down the line to someone that does and say they might want to just look into it?
Oh, I can't. We have no stake in this. As a county, it's not our fight. It's not our purview at all.
Wait a minute. Under the law, right? If you're an agency of the government that's working for the people, and the court system and the police are an agency of government, if the police can come in from the county into town...
Police can come in because police have jurisdiction to come in. The Department of the Environment has no jurisdiction at all. We're a county department. We have... We help to set policy, environmental policy for the county government.
Oh.
We have no land use power.
For the county government, I would highly recommend you put out a thing, do not for any reason cut down old white birch.
You're not listening to me. We can't. That's not within the county's purview. The DEC does have oversight of land use.
Well, they sent us to you.
No, that was the DEP. That's New York City DEP. DEC is the state.
Could you have the DEC call me, please?
I can't have them call you. You can call them.
So
if you'd like, I can give you their phone number.
Unfortunately, I'm in the middle of town on a cell phone with no pad or... I don't have anything to write on.
Then, if you want, you can call me back later, and I'll give you the DEC, or you can look it up.
Tell me the number. I might remember it.
Okay, it's 256.
256.
3000.
3000. And that's who exactly?
That's the DEC. That's the Department of Environmental Conservation, which is a New York State
conservation
agency.
That's what we like, conservation.
Yeah.
Thank you. You've been very helpful.
The other thing is maybe the Town Environmental Commission.
The Town Environmental Commission.
Yeah.
I don't even know if they have one.
They probably do. I don't know.
Woodstock's a small little town.
Oh, I know what Woodstock is.
And actually,
it's not that
politics
small.
Is quite backwards.
Yeah. Well, good luck with this, and I'm sorry that your tree is gone. I do know how important these historical trees are.
Yeah.
Who is responsible?
And how important trees in general are. So, yeah, I do understand where you're coming from, but we have no jurisdiction over it.
Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Take care.
Bye.
Bye.
What'd she say?
I'm no unpaid. I rant about it. But to say, slap the town and say, don't do no more trees. At least rare ones.
Right.
Aid a picture instead of cut them down.
For calling the Department of Environmental Conservation, Region 3, for business hours, or 8:30 a.m. to 4:45 p.m., Monday through Friday. If you would like to dial by last name, press 1. If you need to report an urgent environmental emergency, press 2. For a directory of our programs, press 3. For directions to our regional office or web address, press 4. To be transferred to the operator, press 0. To repeat these choices. Wait while I transfer your call.
Friends of Environmental Conservation. How can I help you?
I'm calling from Woodstock, New York, because the police told me to call the department, the DEP, about a very old birch tree that the town board cut down. And then we talked to several people, and then we were told to talk to the DEC. Is that what you are, Department of Environmental Conservation? So can somebody be sent up to get on this? Because the town board has clearly not acted in a very sensitive way about a very old and rare tree that does not appear to be diseased. And we have all the video, and we're public access producers, so we've announced it on the radio and television. And so we're just...
Let me connect you with our foresters. And
thank you.
If you get a voicemail, definitely leave a message, and they'll return your call as soon as I can, okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. One moment.
She said she's going to put me on somebody's voicemail, and then she's going to return my call, which is interesting. Why would she return the call if she's giving it to the forester?
Because she can't make the decision without discussing with a higher up.
I see. Okay. Makes sense.
Right, that's good. At least she's going to a higher up.
Right.
That's a positive sign.
Right. Dun, 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 dun. I'm growing marijuana in my yard.
Cut that out.
Got a little pots of pot. What? I'm just doing the theme song. Let me get that cute little dog.
Yeah. Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, hello. No, I happen to be down here when she took your message. So you're from Woodstock, and the town cut that tree down? And
Yes, and we'd like somebody to come out and look at it.
Yeah, well, basically...
Actually, we want somebody that can give them a fine. Otherwise, they seem to be beholden to no one, and the police itself sent us to you.
Is it on private land, or...?
No, public land, that's the point. It was done by the town. But we don't know who made such a decision, and so, you know, we need to have somebody with power stand up to a municipal government.
Well, you won't get it from here, because that's a home rule. So, I mean,
home
have
rule.
You contacted...
Home rule. Doesn't home rule mean from the home? The people? We've got the people here.
Yeah, well, the town is considered, you know, home rule by the town. Have you contacted...
But we have proof that it's not home rule by the town. I went to a town board meeting, and I said a simple question. I said, do you see a natural woman standing in front of you? I see somebody with a red shirt, whatever, whatever. Finally, the town supervisor, Jeremy Wilbur, had to step in and say, no, I do not. So if you go to public meetings and you're not recognized as a woman or a man with rights, then you depend on agencies like you. Otherwise, there's no home. These people do not represent us. They represent corporate interests. And due process is about what I'm doing right now. I don't want to sound...
Okay, well, hold on. Have you spoken to the Tree Commission CAC there? Because there's people there that...
Can you give me that number and I'll call them?
Actually, I don't have them. I don't have that number.
Find that number. And repeat again what I'm looking for, and I want to write down every word you're saying.
Well, it's the Woodstock, it would be the Woodstock Tree Commission or the Woodstock CAC, Conservation Advisory Council.
CAC,
Conservation Advisory Council.
Conservation Advisory
Council.
CISORY Council.
Yeah, because I met with them about a year ago. We went up Main Street, looked at different trees and stuff, and they know a lot of trees need work in Woodstock. But they'd also, you know, fight for the trees that, you know, should be, you know, pruned and not cut down and stuff, you know, and things. So they would be the best people to start with.
So you've been up here. That's great. What's your name?
That was a year ago. George Profus.
George, G-E-O-R-G-E. And how do you spell your last name?
It's P-R-O-F-O-U-S.
F-O-U-S. Okay,
great.
Oh yeah, so I do have an income here.
So you've been here a year ago. So if I go up to the town, I can give them this information, and I can find a responsible party.
Well, yeah, you definitely should talk to the conservation, the CAC Conservation Advisory Council, and that, I know they have a subset, which is the Tree Commission, and you should talk to them. They do a lot with emerald ash borer.
We've heard all kinds of things about the ash, for sure.
Right. So, if you look that up, his name just escaped me. It shouldn't, because I've known him for so many years, but...
If you think of the name, could you call me back? Yeah. It would help
me. Okay.
Okay?
All right.
Thank you, John.
Okay, yeah. Do you have a... Hold on. Do you have a... Can you give me your number? Hold on.
Yes,
can you write that?
I thought you had one of those automatic callback things.
No, we don't.
I love it that you're taking it down by hand. It's 845-901-1114.
1114.
And thank you so much,
George.
And
what was your name?
My name is Paula Gloria Barton, and you spoke to my husband,
Paula.
Joe Barton. And we're Woodstock TV producers, and also we're on radio Woodstock 104. So if there's something that we don't know about this tree that made it be cut down, we will apologize for any alarm that we've caused, but all of our...
Well, this didn't happen to be, I know a big white birch that was behind the information center.
Yes, that one.
Are you kidding? That was it, huh?
Yes.
Okay, that was just a guess.
I love it, George. You're my man. Thank you.
Well, I mean,
you're familiar with the issue. That's what I'm saying.
Well, I saw the tree a year ago. I have no idea why they cut it down.
So I'm going to go to the CAC and whatever, and if you give me a name, it'll be helpful for me to find it.
All right, I'll see if I can find it, and I'll get back to you.
Thank you. Bye.
All right, bye-bye.
You don't want to talk about the page 3 girls? Because Ugly George said that's how the European Union got their website jump started.
No.
Okay.